A Google search of her name brings up very little personal details. But here on the streets of the Democratic Republic of Congo, Marie Olive Kabila is a rock star of sorts. When she's out in public, which is very rare, the crowds, well, they just can't get enough of her. Mrs. Kabila is the First Lady of the Democratic Republic of Congo. She's married to President Joseph Kabila, one of Africa's youngest leaders. She rarely does media interviews, or for that matter, speaks publicly. And so her participation in a recent Christian event drew national attention and came as a surprise to many in her country.
People of God, this is a very special day for me.
In a small church on the east side of the capital city of Kinshasa, hundreds of people gathered recently as Mrs. Kabila declared 3 days of nationwide prayer and fasting.
I am here to tell you that I will never be ashamed of my Lord's name. We need him desperately to heal our country.
The Democratic Republic of Congo, or DRC, is what some would say cursed by its natural resources. You name it, it has everything. Diamonds, copper, gold, cobalt, zinc, the list goes on. But for all its riches, the DRC is a mess. Politically, economically, socially, and according to Mrs. Kabila, spiritually dying.
Dear Father, our people are suffering. We need you, Lord.
According to the CIA, more than 5 million people have died here since 1998 from famine, violence, and disease. Eastern Congo, home to the majority of the country's wealth, is also ground zero of the worst war on the continent at the moment. Despite a peace agreement, government troops are still fighting to ward off rebel groups from taking control of the minerals. Hundreds of thousands of people have been displaced and tens of thousands of women raped, tortured, and mutilated.
We have all the mineral wealth in the world. We are like the promised land, but we are flowing with death and destruction.
With the blessing of her husband, Mrs. Kabila launched a prayer campaign, placing billboards like this in all the major cities. She took to the airwaves, pleading for her countrymen to join her, and the response was overwhelming. For 3 days, Congolese around the country gathered in their churches.
The First Lady is setting an example for us and calling us to pray for each other.
And for someone who is incredibly shy, reserved, and often shuns the public spotlight, it was this image of their First Lady raising her hands and crying out to God that touched so many people. Theodore Mugalu serves as the presidential couple's spiritual advisor.
The First Lady is a strong person of faith. She knows that it's only through prayer that we can face the Goliaths of our culture. That's why these days are so important.
3 days after launching the prayer and fasting campaign, at a packed soccer stadium, tens of thousands of people gathered to worship and pray. Several of the country's top Christian artists were on hand to perform.
And why is this event so significant? You see, you have to understand, in the political history of the Democratic Republic of Congo, no sitting leader has ever called for days of prayer and fasting. And so what the First Lady is doing today is monumental.
I want you to know that the President is supporting us today, even though he's not here.
And even though it marked the end of the 3 days of prayer and fasting, Mrs. Kabila urged her countrymen not to stop, but to keep praying.
This is just the beginning. We want to be set free from the devil and the evil spirits that run to and fro in our nation. I believe the walls of Jericho are falling. God is going to set our nation free.
And once again, to the surprise of so many here, the First Lady, accompanied by a famous Congolese Christian singer, ended the prayer campaign by singing, asking for the Spirit of God to fall upon her nation. George Thomas, CBN News, Kinshasa, in the Democratic Republic of Congo.